What's good, Night Nation? We just started the Recovery album review on the Patreon, two songs in, and I just did the talking to myself. And I'm not waiting. I just want to post this on YouTube now. We're gonna do it for Marshall Monday, but I'm doing it now because I just want to talk about it now. That song was fire as hell, and it just had me saying a lot, thinking a lot, all of that, man. Eminem is fucking goated out this bitch, bro. Give y'all a little intro as to what's going on, because it's gonna say Patreon this, Patreon that, man. But fuck that, we doing this shit for everybody right now. Tap into the Patreon, of course, for all the extra good stuff, man. But we're not gonna hold on to this. We're gonna let everybody see this one now. All right, man. Love y'all. I'm out. What up, what up, what up, Night Nation? It's your boy, Stevie Knight. Man, Eminem Recovery album review. Goddamn. If you here, you already know what it is, bro. Patreon shit all day, every day. Let's get it. We're doing Eminem Talking to Myself. I heard this is a monster. Heard this is a monster. In whatever way, it's a monster, but I heard it's a monster. Let's tap in, man. Let's get it. Let's get it, man. You know what we're here to do. Let's go.
Hey, yo. Before I start this song, man, I just wanna thank everybody for being so patient and bearing with me over these last couple of years while I figure this shit out.
I mean, I was about to say, isn't it crazy for someone to be as popular as Eminem to feel like he's out here by himself? But I understand how that takes place. Like, mentally, they feel like they're alone because they feel like nobody's there for them. And he's going through the struggle he's going through. But isn't it crazy how that can happen, though? You know what I'm saying? Like, he's talking to himself. With the number of people I'd imagine Eminem talks to every day. But that means nothing. Just because they talk to you has nothing to do with motherfuckers really, like, fucking with you, knowing you. You know what I mean? Who could care less about who, about Eminem? You know what I mean? That's real, bro. That's real. That's how you know. But I say this shit all the time. That's how you know. That's real, man. That's real. Who really there for me? If he had motherfuckers out there really there for him, he wouldn't be feeling like he's talking to himself, because motherfuckers would know. And they'd be there to help his ass out.
Up some lanes, but there was no one who even knew I was going through growing pains. Hatred was flowing through my veins, on the verge of going insane. I almost made a song dissing Lil Wayne. It's like I was jealous of him because of the attention he was getting. I felt horrible about myself. He was spitting and I wasn't. Anyone who was buzzing back then could have got it. Almost went at Kanye too. God, it feels like I'm going psychotic.
So was he saying that? Because, I mean, there hasn't ever been a time where Wayne or Kanye have been, like, legitimately more popping than Eminem, more popular than Eminem, right? I don't think there's, even with as big as Lil Wayne has gotten at the peak of his career, and as Kanye as well, like, you put the pillar back, no one has been more popping and relevant as Eminem throughout the entirety of his career. So I'm thinking that since he found himself in those dark places at times, and he probably let the criticism and the ridicule affect him the way it did. He probably didn't feel like he was as popping as he literally is, and looked at these other motherfuckers that were moving units and had all this popularity and took that shit as like a slight towards him. But it's probably just he was delusional at that point. Like, regardless, even when Eminem was, you know, hit his lowest points, he was still trending. You know what I mean? He was still Eminem. That was his own mental struggle that he had. That's why he said, I almost popped off at Lil Wayne, almost popped off at Kanye, but I had to check myself and really understand what was taking place. It was probably just me fucking with myself. It wasn't really what it was. What I saw was not really the case.
It feels like I'm going psychotic. Thank God that I didn't do it. I'd have had my ass handed to me, and I knew it, but proof isn't here.
See, but that's cap though. That's cap. He don't really believe that shit he's saying. He's just taking the humble route. Thank God that I didn't do it. Go at Kanye or Wayne, even though him going at Wayne would have been delicious for hip hop. I talked about that shit in that last video I did when somebody had put this compilation of music together that they said M was taking shots at Wayne. I tended not to agree with the assessment that they had. But if that had actually taken place, Eminem and Wayne rap beef, that would have been so fucking dope for hip hop. Eminem would have won. Eminem would have won. Not because he raps better than Wayne. I mean, that's debatable. But Eminem is willing to go where no one else is willing to go. Wayne is not going to go to the edge of the earth like Eminem would on some rap beef shit. And on top of the fact that he can rap the way he raps, like Eminem is impossible to beat. You know what I mean? So I would have got my ass handed to me. That's cap. He's just saying that because he's being humble.
To me, and I knew it, but proof isn't here to see me through it. I'm in the booth, popping another pill, trying to talk myself into it. Are you stupid? You hooked on dissing people for no reason, especially when you can't even write a decent punchline. Even you're lying to yourself.
He's probably thought that when he was in rehab and wasn't doing music and saw Wayne and Kanye popping because he took some time off. But that's on you, big dog. That's on you, play. You can't blame them. You can't blame other motherfuckers for doing their thing when you're not around. If you wasn't around, you'd be right there with them. But we know that. It's just, I'm just responding to what I'm hearing. You know what I mean? It's just interesting seeing how his fucking brain works. He was delusional as shit.
To yourself, you're slowly dying, you're denying, your health is declining with your self-esteem. You're crying out
yep.
for help.
I'd imagine how that conversation would sound with Eminem when he has a low self-esteem and does not feel like he's up to par, you know, along with his standards, talking to somebody else. Like, how would somebody receive, like M, this is Eminem, what the fuck you mean you don't, this is what you do, bro? Like, it would be hard for, like, me, I'm thinking about myself being in that person that Eminem's talking to when he's like confiding in me, trying to get me to understand why he thinks he can't rap well anymore, or he's not a good rapper, or these other motherfuckers are better than him. Like, motherfucker, are you dumb? Like, just delusional. He was just at a low point. His self-esteem was just fucking low. So I'd have to understand that his self-esteem was just low and his perception may have been a little off. He just needed his confidence back. Yeah, I mean, that goes in anything. It'd be the fucking best basketball player or football player. It's mental. Like, if you don't have this shit straight, then you can't do anything that you have been, you know, blessed with gift-wise. You're the best basketball player shooting. If his confidence is low, he's not hitting any shots because he just doesn't think that he can do it. But once he gets that back, it's just how it is, right? It's just how it is. Same shit with Eminem. It's dope. Yeah, you are.
Do I feel so alone? Nobody but me. I'm on my own. Is there anyone out there who feels the way I feel? That there isn't let me in, so I know that I'm not most of your alone.
Look, though, this is like a vulnerable ass song. That's dope for everybody, because if Eminem is feeling this way, then I should not feel bad at all for me feeling the way I feel. If this rapping ass motherfucker feels like he can't rap no more, then whatever I'm going through, I can get through it. Just being self-aware and knowing what the fuck is going on. Like, you feel like shit. It's okay. You're human, right? You're human. We all human. We all get to them low points. But the goal is get your ass up at that low point, right? Right? And then here we got a motherfucker that's telling the whole world what he went through. Come on, man.
That's a bitter pill to swallow. All I know is I'm wallowing, self-loathing and hollow. Bottoms up on the pill bottom.
Have I heard this song before? Have I done a reaction to this? I think I made this part sounds familiar. Marshall, you're no longer the man. That's a bitter pill to swallow. All I know is I'm wallowing, self-loathing and hollow bottoms. I feel like I've seen this part of this video. And the only reason you ain't the man is because you got hooked up on drugs, bro. Bottoms up on the pill bottle. Maybe I hit my bottom tomorrow. My soul echoes in this hall though. But I must be talking to the wall though. I don't see nobody else. I guess I keep joking to myself. But all these other rappers suck is all that I know. I've turned into a hater. I put up a false bravado, but most... See, that's fucked up. That's how you find yourself in fucked up positions. Since you going through some shit, you going to... put that negative energy out on others who are undeserving of it. But all this is a reflection of the fucked up places you got yourself in, right? But it would take somebody very mature to understand that he's just going through some shit and not take what he's saying as offensive. But it's Eminem. This is, he's a king of this shit going at motherfuckers next. And if he feel like this motherfucker's doing, like Eminem felt that way to like potentially spit venom at other motherfuckers because he feels shitty. But it's still Eminem that's going to spit that venom. So venom he spits is going to dig in your ass. So regardless of where it's coming from and how shitty he feels and how low his self-esteem is, like a motherfucker's still a man. Right? It's not on the person receiving that shit to, you know, digest that. Is he just going through some shit? Eminem talking crazy? Fuck, you better check yourself, bro. You better check yourself, dog. You know what I'm saying? Now, I've turned into a hater. I put up this false bravado. It's dope that he checked himself before he let that shit out. You know what I mean? Even though that Eminem, Lil Wayne rap beef would have been dope, it would have only been dope if it was like some credible shit. If it came because Eminem was just in a dark place and wanted to just go at Wayne just because he feels shitty, that would have been fucked up. That would have been fucked up, and it would have been bad for Eminem's legacy. But it was on some, like, who's the best on some competitive shit. Yeah, 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 we like that. We like that. So that's not an egomaniac, that's not his motto. He's not a desperado, he's desperate. His thoughts are bottled inside him, one foot on the brake. He's not a desperado. Hold on. He did a lot there. He's been doing a lot the whole time, but I'm so focused on what he's saying as opposed to how he's saying it right now. This is one of those songs because he's letting this shit out. He's letting this shit out. Also, that's not an egomaniac. That's not his motto. He's not a desperado. He's desperate. His thoughts are bottled inside him. One foot on the brake, one on the throttle. Falling asleep at writer's block in the parking lot of McDonald's. But instead of feeling sorry for yourself, do something about it. Yeah. Admit you got a problem. Your brain is clouded. You pouted long enough. It isn't them, it's you, you fucking baby. We're worried about what they do when you're shady. I'm fucking going crazy. Just took the words out of my mouth. That's what I've been saying this whole damn time. So I picked myself up off the ground and fucking swam before I drowned. Okay, I thought he said something. Off the ground and fucking swam before I drowned. Hit my bottom so hard I bounced twice. Suffice, this time around it's different. Said I hit my bottom so hard I bounced twice. It's a double. You hit fucking, you fall so hard from so high. He was so high that if he hits the ground, he's falling a long way. So you hit that bitch hard. You know what I'm saying? I'm probably just being loud in the mic, but... That's a double just on the image that he's painting for you. Something falling from very high is gonna bounce. So it's just a whole metaphor of how high he's falling from. But he's falling because of his own doing. It's not because he's getting torn down by the spectators. He's doing this shit to himself. So he's falling from that high on his own, bouncing back twice. But this also could be like he bounced twice. Maybe he got two chances, right? He found himself in a fucked up circumstance. He got up out that bitch bouncing metaphorically, and it hit another motherfucking low point and bounced back from that. You know what I mean? Ran for a drown. Hit my bottom so hard I bounced twice. Suffice, this time around it's different. Them last 2 hours didn't count. Encore, I was on drugs. Relapse, I was flushing them out. And the relapse he got, that's why he was talking all crazy. Flushing them drugs out. That's dope. And encore is kind of, eh. So that means recovery is going to be fire. based on how he described that shit, that means recovery is gonna be fire. All right. I was flushing them out. I've come to make it up to you now. No more fucking around. I got something to prove to fans because I feel like I let them down. Let's go. Please accept my apology. I finally feel like I'm back to normal. I feel like me again. Let me formally reintroduce myself to you for those of you who don't know. The new me's back to the old me and homie, I don't show no signs of slowing up when I'm blowing. That was hard. That was hard how he said that shit. I feel like I'm me again, finally. Let me formally reintroduce myself to you for those of you who don't know. The new me is back. Old me and homie, I don't show no signs of slowing up, pulling up, blowing up all over. Let's go, bro. That's tough. I feel like me again. Let me formally reintroduce myself to you for those of you who don't know. The new me's back to the old me and homie, I don't show no signs of slowing up, blowing up, blowing up all over. My life is no longer a movie, but the show ain't over, homo. Let's go. I'm back with a vengeance, homie. Weezy, keep your head up. That's hot, that's fire, because he just said what he said. I was gonna go with these motherfuckers because I was so fucked up. Yeah, but he turned it, he flipped it. He wants some positive shit. Instead of dissing you, I'm gonna lift you up, uplift your ass. Weezy, keep your head up. T.I., keep your head up. Kanye, keep your head up. I'm thinking they all may have been going through some shit at this point or somewhere around this shit. I mean, I know T.I. had trouble with the law at one point. Kanye, I can't remember back then. Weezy had trouble with the law too, but. Just keep slaying them. Rest in peace to DJM, cause I know what it's like. I struggle with this shit every single day and I'm. Shit hit harder when you know what the fuck going on. And where you know where it. I know, man, if I did a reaction to this, I would know what's going on. But it hits harder because I know exactly where it's coming from. Yep. Do I feel so alone? Nobody but me. I'm on my own. It's a reason when I'm bad. It feels the way I feel that there isn't like me. And so I know that I'm not the only one. So it is. Damn. Yeah. Feels like I just woke up or something. Yeah. I guess I just
forgot who the fuck I was, man.
I imagine that's easy to do, though, man. Like, just because, I don't know. Got you reflecting. I could imagine how I talk about it all the time. I talk about it all the time. Like, even though I can imagine how somebody could feel alone being as popular as Eminem, because when you are this big, you're like permanently VIP platinum status, and only a certain motherfuckers can get around you. And these motherfuckers that can't get around you probably don't even fuck with you. You know what I'm saying? It's hard for other people who are not accustomed to that lifestyle to relate with you. You know what I mean? And you probably are really paranoid about letting motherfuckers in because you don't know who's really there for you. You know what I'm saying? So, him saying, I guess I forgot who I was, man. Like, you got all the money in the world. The world is your oyster. Why the fuck are you forgetting who you are? But I'd imagine that's pretty easy to forget who you are if you went from fucking shit to sugar the way he did, where you literally came from the slums, the lowest of the lows, to the highest of the highs. It's only so much the fucking mind and the spirit can go through if you're doing this shit on your own. You know what I'm saying? He got fucked up with drugs at one point, relationship and doing shit, and you know, fucking fighting society and all types of shit, man. He's motherfucker been through a lot, bro. That's all it comes down to. Motherfucker been through a lot, and any person could find themselves in this position. But it's just, when I go back thinking about it, it's just, his story is just, it's crazy. Yo, it's anybody I thought about going at. It was never nothing personal. Some shit I was going through. It's everybody else. I'm back. That's tough. Hit a whole lot different. Man. Fuck with it. Definitely fuck with it, man. Definitely fuck with it. So, Cold Wind Blows, fire. Talking to Myself, fire. We 2 for 2. 2 for 2. I'm going to remember both of these tracks. Even though I did Cold Wind Blows, but I like this one better than Cold Wind Blows, though, because it was such a introspective type of song. You know what I'm saying? We've heard Eminem talk shit all the goddamn time. And I don't take that for granted, but I like this. When he's like, you know what I'm saying, bearing his soul. You know what I mean? Anyway, I fuck with it. Definitely fuck with it, man. So we out here, recovery album review. That's two of them things this week. I'm gonna try to fucking keep up to what I'm saying. Y'all better help hold me accountable. You know what I'm saying? We out here. Two a week. That's the goal. Two a week. Anyway, man, love y'all, man. I'm out.